Hey, what's up, guys? It's Obsessive Man here with another reaction. So today I'm reacting to an artist that I don't know a lot about. I've heard I think one or two of his songs before, and they were extremely good. I think it was Summertime High Time, and I forgot the name of the other one, but it was a few years ago, and I remember it was extremely unique, extremely good. And yeah, it's just been a long time since I've heard any of his music, so that's what I want to do today. I want to react to some of his newer music, see how he's changed over the years, because I think his other songs that I listened to were from like 4 or 5 years ago, maybe 3. So it's been a while, so I want to see how he has evolved as an artist, even though I don't remember much of the other songs. I just remember them being really good and really unique. So yeah, this is going to be my first time ever listening to Kuko in like 4 years. So, Kuko Time Machine. So what I love about Kuko is just like the overall sound is so unique. Like I had never heard anything like him until I heard him for the first time. The instrumentals are just so unique. I don't even know what type of music it is, honestly. It's just so different and so unique and so good. But also he's got a very unique sound to his voice, and also like the lyrics, for example. The lyrics in this are very touching and very relatable. Like, who doesn't wish they could go back in time and change, like, so many things, you know, like to see people they can't see anymore because they passed away, or make different decisions and not hurt people, you know. So very relatable, very good. So this is exactly what I was expecting from Kuko. Just very different yet so good, you know. Thank you. Oh, that was so good, man. It's very freaking good. The instrumental is very beautiful, very unique. I love the overall sound. I like his voice. I like, the message is so relatable, so sad, so unique. Just, yeah, man, that's what you get from Kuko, man. You get so much uniqueness. I like seeing that, man. Because music nowadays is trash. So listening to artists like this just makes me happy, makes me emotional. It makes me just appreciate their art, you know? And I know there's really good artists out there that are not famous. It's just the music that gets popular that sucks, you know? So when I hear artists that are good and unique, it just makes me happy and it makes me appreciate their music even more. Even, like, especially when they're not famous, because they're staying true to their art, you know? Because you could always switch up and make the same music that everybody fucking makes and have a bigger chance of making it, you know? But then you would just be lying to yourself and your art. So that's why I stay true to my sound and the music that I want to make, even though it's very different. Because I don't want to sound like everything else, you know? I want to be unique. I want to be myself. And if people don't want to hear it, then that's fine. I'll just keep doing it for myself. So it's that's why I like Kuko and artists like him so much, because they're so different. And yeah, it just gives artists like me hope that you can always make it, even when you're making different art than what most people like. So yeah, all in all, beautiful. It's what can you expect from Kuko, right? Just, he's so freaking talented.